My Hero Academia Chapter 292 was absolutely insane. It was borderline incredible with some of the most incredible stuff happening here. On one hand, we had the entire shenanigans surrounding the battle between Best Genius and Gigantomachia. And on the other hand, we had the family feud gone wrong between Shoto and Dabi. Then there is Deku, who is trying its best to get up. And then there is Nejire, who is burned to an absolute crisp. And at the very end of all of this, there was this. Power. I was absolutely amazed by this entire thing, and when I saw the spoilers for this particular thing, I was just beyond dumbfounded. I'm just so happy to see that Mirio is finally making a return, and this was possibly one of the best way in which he is reintroduced into the story. Of course, there's a lot of discussion as to what exactly is going on here and how exactly did he get back his powers. Was Eri actually successful in giving back his powers? Or was this something related to Overall's anti-quirk bullets which he had in the very beginning? We have many questions in relation to all of this, but even more than that, one particular fan opinion is popping up in the fandom of My Hero Academia, and it was also very prevalent in my video where I covered the spoilers of My Hero Academia Chapter 292. So hello and welcome to UnderwiseZ, my name is Soham and we need to talk about this as to whether this is actually Mirio or Limilian or this is a disguised Toga. But before that, if you're new here, then please consider subscribing to the channel since I do weekly anime and manga related content. We're also trying to hit 5,000 subscribers by the end of 2020, so a like and sub would be massively appreciated. Currently, we are at about 3,700 subs, so it's not that far away. So if you guys want to show some support to the channel, then please do subscribe. But anyway, let's talk about this entire thing. So the major debate among the fandom right now is whether this is actually a returning Mirio or is this a disguised Toga. Now there is some merit in both the thought processes, but I'll give my justification and clarification for this entire matter in a bit. But first of all, let's talk about what exactly this theory is trying to say. This theory basically wants to say that Toga, whom we last saw after the fight with Ochako, has basically disguised herself into Mirio and has jumped into the fray in order to hurt the Hero Society from the inside. What exactly is going on here is that she will try to befriend or be a part of the Hero team for a while, and when the moment or opportunity is right, she will try to attack Deku or some other important member of the Hero Society. This might actually be the grand plan of the League of Villains as a whole, via which they will probably be able to rupture the Hero Society. Now yes, granted, this is a very good fan theory and it does have a lot of credit. This will make for a very interesting change of pace for the entire story, and this will be a really big bait switch for everyone. But I highly doubt that this is actually the case. I'm strongly, 100% strongly in the favor that this is actually Mirio, this is actually Limilian himself who has come back to the action. And let me give my opinion or justification for this entire thing. Now the very first thing that we need to talk about is the quirk of Himiko Toga. Now her quirk is basically transform, which allows her to transform into the body of a person whose blood she has consumed. Now this particular fan theory suggests the fact that she might have collected Mirio's blood from the entire overall situation which happened a while back, especially when he was trying to protect Eri. I agree that that's a very nice prediction, but there's a very big flaw in that particular thing. Yes, Toga's quirk does allow her to transform into any person whose blood she has consumed, and she's also able to use the quirk of that particular user. And this is especially true after the awakening of her quirk. But the major problem here is the fact that she has to have prior knowledge of how exactly Mirio's quirk works. Now of course the League of Villain does have some data in this particular regard, I'm pretty sure about it, but Mirio's quirk is not a very superpowered quirk. It's a very difficult quirk to master in the very first place. If you'll remember, then Sun Eater, who is actually the childhood friend of Limilian, told everyone that this particular quirk, that is permeability, is a very difficult quirk to master. And Mirio had a lot of problem as a kid in order to maintain this particular quirk. And it was only due to sheer dedication and hard work via which he actually managed to master this particular difficult quirk. And now this has become one of his greatest assets. So it is very unlikely that Toga will be able to master a quirk like this. And especially after seeing how this character emerged from the ground, it's very unlikely for me to think that Toga actually managed to master the quirk permeability in such a short span of time. That's borderline impossible. And not only that, one more thing is very essential here. Okay, granted, for a moment I did believe that it is actually Toga who is trying to disguise herself as a hero so that she will backstab the heroes later on after this entire fight is over. That's fine. But even before that, we actually get to see Mirio before in this particular chapter, before he tries to protect Best Genist. Yes, it all happened in front of the Nomus who were fighting the heroes at a different location. At that moment, if you remember, Endeavor's sidekick Burning was about to be engulfed by a snake-like Nomu, and that particular Nomu was defeated by a single punch. And who was that punch? It is, of course, without a shadow of doubt, Lemelian himself. If at all that was actually Toga, why would she even protect Burning in the very first place? She would directly head over to the location of Gigantomachia, right? And on the topic of Gigantomachia, a very important thing here to note is that he was trying to break free of best genius attacks and binding forces when Shigaraki told him to break free. The entire League of Villains was trying to help him in this particular thing, and that is when the Nomus were trying to attack best genius as well. So if that was actually Toga in a disguise, then why would she even stop the rampage of Gigantomachia? Why would she help best genius? Without a shadow of doubt, this is Mirio himself. I am almost 100% sure that this is Mirio and this is not a disguised Toga because of the aforementioned reasons. Moreover, now the biggest question is that how exactly did Mirio get back his quirk? I have two particular theories in this particular regard. Of course, there is Eri, who has possibly mastered her quirk and has been able to grant back Lemelian his quirk. And the other theory is in relation to Overhaul and how he had the anti-bullets, anti-quirk bullets, which he had developed in order to monopolize the nation. Remember the overall arc. There was a mention of this particular thing. Of course, we are going to get more backstory and information about all of this in the upcoming chapters, but this was an absolutely glorious way of introducing Lemelian back into the story. This was awesome. Sir Nighteye would be proud of him. Deku would be proud of him. Everyone would be proud of him. This was absolutely awesome, and everyone was flabbergasted by the reintroduction of Mirio, best boy Mirio. This was absolutely awesome. But there you have it. I hope this video will clear all your doubts in regards to this particular theory which is going on in the fandom. It's not a bad theory in any way, but I 100% for sure believe that this is actually Mirio who has actually come back after getting back his powers. So what do you guys think about all of this? Please mention your thoughts in the comment section below. So that's it for today guys, thank you so much for watching. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like it, share it with your friends and subscribe to the channel for more. This is WonderYZ and I'll see you soon in the next video.